Hello guys and welcome to this series of shell scripting. In this video we are going to create a shell script to read the content of a CSV file and to perform certain operation on it. So let's begin. Now before we proceed with the creation of shell script, let's first see what we are trying to accomplish. Suppose we have a CSV file with these contents in which name, designation and salary are the parameters. And each field has certain values. Now, when I will execute my shell script and I'll pass this CSV file, then it should give me formatted output. For example, for the entry number 1, it should give me output as name is Sordeep, position is developer and salary is 12,000. Similarly, for the next entry, it should give me output as name is Abhishek, position is solution architect and its salary. Like that, for each entry, we need a proper formatted output. Along with that, we need to calculate the average of all the salaries, and in the end it should give me the average salaries whatever is the value, correct? So we should be able to get the formatted output and also the average salary. Now there are few points that you need to know about the read command before you start creating the shell script. The first point is that the read command uses the IFS to determine its word splitting character. For instance, currently if we see the value of IFS, then it is set to space, tab and new line character. Okay, so if we write here read, then let's say var 1 and var 2, and after that if I provide any values, for instance val 1 and val 2, then value 1 is going to be assigned with the variable 1 and value 2 will be assigned to the variable 2. Okay. The space at this moment is acting as a word splitting character for the read command. So if I press enter, do here echo of $var1, the value will be val1. Okay. Similarly, for the var2, the value that is assigned to it is val2. Now if we change the value of the IFS, then the word splitting character for the read command will also change. For example, suppose I am setting the IFS as comma. Okay. Then I am writing here read var1 and var2, right? So in this case I need to write here val1 comma val2. So in this particular case val1 will get assigned to the variable 1 while the val2 will get assigned to the variable 2, right? So if we press enter, do here echo of $var1, then it is assigned to the val1, and if we do here dollar of var2, it will be assigned with the value of value 2. Let's see another example in which I am changing the delimiter with the dollar. It means that our read command will keep on reading the input as long as it is not getting this dollar character. By default this character is slash n, then I will provide here variable 3 and also the variable 4. Notice currently our IFS is set to comma, right? So if I press enter, give here value as let's say value 3 comma value 4. Okay, I'll press enter, give here another thing, let's say good day, right? And after that I'll provide the dollar. Now in this particular case value 3 will get assigned to the var 3 and value 4, then slash n, that is new line character, and good day is assigned to the variable 4. Okay, so if we write here echo then dollar var 3, we will see it has the value of value 3, correct? But if we are providing here variable number 4, then you will see its value will be value 4 and then new line good day. Okay, this value get assigned to the variable 4. So this was the first point, that read command uses the IFS to determine its word splitting characters while taking the input. Now the second point is that we can also pass the here document or here string to read command. For instance, if I am writing here read x then y, and then I can use here string, and after that I can provide the input, that is good comma day. Okay, so this particular text will act as an standard input to the read command. Okay, remember right now the word splitting character is comma, so in this particular case x will get assigned with the value of good while the y would get assigned with the value of day. So if I press enter, do here echo of $x, the value is good, and if we do here echo of $y, the value is day. Okay, now let's create our shell script keeping these two points in mind. So first of all, we'll create a variable with the name file and I will assign it with the value of $1. Okay, this value we will pass it from the command line as a file name, right? And also I will set the ifs as /n. This is because so that I can first read the content of a file line by line, okay? Then we will write here for line in $cat, and I'll provide the argument as file, okay? Then do done and echo $line. So this is the simple script that will keep on printing the content of a file line by line. So if we save it and execute our shell script, that is .\readcsv, and I'll pass the argument as filecsv.csv. So it will give me the output. Now we had already discussed this shell script in some other video. You can check that out. Now after that, if you notice our CSV file, you will see that each line have three values and the values are separated with the comma, right? So I'll set the ifs variables value as comma, and then I will use the read command. Since there are three fields, so I'm going to use the three different variables. So let's write here name for the name, des for designation, and cell for the salary. And I'll provide here here string, and inside the here string I will be passing the current line. So suppose it is reading the first line. So in that particular case, what will happen? This will get replaced with the read name des cell, and inside the here document we are going to pass here name comma designation comma salary. This is during the first iteration, right? So in this particular case, name will get assigned with the variable name, designation will get assigned with the variable des, and salary will get assigned with the cell. Okay, now in the second iteration, what will happen? Saurabh will get assigned to the variable name, developer will get assigned to the des variable, and 12,000 will get assigned to the cell variable. Correct. In the third iteration, Abhishek will get assigned to the name, solution architect will get assigned to the des, and the 1 lakh will get assigned to the cell, right? So in each iteration, different values will get assigned to these variables. Okay, now after that, we simply need to print the value of these variables. Now to print the value of this variable, I can use the echo command, but for this video I am going to use the cat command and will use the here document. Okay, and after that I'll use the dash, and I'll provide here limit string as close, right? After that I'll write here name is, then $name, correct, then designation is $des, and finally salary is $cell, and after that I'll provide several equals to characters. Okay, so let's save it, and if we execute our shell script, it is giving us the syntax error because I also need to provide our limit string at the end. So before done, I'm going to write here close. Okay, so let's save it, and if we again execute our shell script, we will see that we are able to get the formatted output. Okay, now even though our output is formatted, there are certain operations that we need to do. First of all, we need to remove this particular line. Okay, these are the headers, and I don't want the headers to be shown in the output, right? So for that we are going to use another variable with the name c. Okay, then we will use as a counter variable also, right? So I'll write here c, and I'm going to assign it with the value of -1, right? And then in each iteration we will increment the value of c. So when the first iteration will come, it will hit the line c++ and increment the value of c by 1. Okay, since it was -1, now the new value will become the 0. Okay, so I'll write here if then double parenthesis c equal 0, right? Then we simply need to skip this particular loop. So I'll write here continue. Okay, so again if we see that first of all c is assigned with the value of -1, right? Then we are using our loop, and inside the loop I'm incrementing the value of c by 1 in each iteration. So in the first iteration it get incrementing by 1, and the current value will become 0. Okay, and notice currently the line holded by the line variable is the header line, right? So this particular line will get skipped. So following code after the if will not work since we are using the continue. Okay, in the next iteration the line will be holding the value of this particular line, that is the actual data, and c value will get incremented by 1 again. So previously the value had become 0 and now it has become 1. Okay, so this particular condition will get false and the program execution will go outside the if block. Okay, so this code will get executed, right? And the same will keep on happening for the other entries also. So if we save it and again execute our shell script, then we will see the header line is not getting printed, right? Now after that, we also need to sum the salary of all the employees or all the entries. For that, we will create another variable with the value as 0. Okay, so I'll write here sum equals to 0, and then after the read command, I'm simply going to write here sum equals to, okay, or sum plus equals to cell, right? So in the first iteration, our headers will get skipped. But in the second iteration, whatever is the value holded by the salary will get added to the sum variable. Okay. Similarly, for the next iteration, it will again get updated and it will keep on updating its value as long as the loop will run. Okay. And at the end, we will be able to get the sum of all the salaries, right? So if we print here after this cat and after this loop echo dollar, and then we will write here sum. And if we again execute our shell script, you will see at the end we are able to get the sum of all the salaries, right? Now we need to find the average, so we also need to find the total number of actual entries present there, that is the total number of entries apart from the headers. Okay, so for that we are already using this counter variable, that is C. So in the first iteration, C was 0, that was used for the header, right? For the next iteration, C value will become 1 for the first actual entry. Similarly, for the second entry, the C value will become 2. For the third, it will become 3. For the fourth, it will become 4, and keep on it will incrementing its value as long as the loop will run. Okay. So at the end, C will have the total number of required entries. Okay. So if we write here C, okay, also the sum with C, and save it and again execute our shell script. Okay, so let's execute it. We will see total number of effective entries, that is apart from the headers, are 5. Also, if we see our CSV file, you will see this is our first entry, second entry, third, fourth and fifth. Okay, so now we are able to get the sum of all the salaries and also the total number of entries, right? And the formula for average is the sum upon total number of entries. So we can simply write here average is then dollar $AVG, and I will be assigning the value of AVG with the sum divided by C. Okay, so let's save it and again execute our shell script. Let me expand it. If you see, this is the output of our shell script that we were expecting at the very beginning of the video. Okay, we are passing the file as an argument to our shell script. It is giving us the formatted output, and at the end it is able to find the average. Now there is one more point that I want to tell you, is that instead of using the multiple variables here, for instance, currently we are using 3 different variables, right? But suppose CSV file have 10 headers. In that particular case, using 10 different variables is not a suitable idea. So to eliminate that, we can also use the array. Okay, so instead of using the normal variable, we can use the dash a option, which is used to read the array, and then we can define any array variable. For instance, I'm writing here data. So in this particular case, data 0 will have the first value, okay, at the 0th index. Data 1, that is the index number 1, will have the second value, and data 2, that is the second index, will have the third value. For instance, suppose this is our CSV file. So in this particular case, for any iteration, data 0 will have the name, let's say Abhishek. Data 1 will have the position, that is solution architect, and data 2, that is the second index, will have its salary. Okay, so instead of writing here name, I can also write here now data 0, then data 1, and here we can write here data 2, and during the sum also we can provide here data 2. So let's save it, and if we again execute our shell script, you will see we are getting the same output even right now. So this is how we can create a shell script to read CSV file, or to access any value of a CSV file, or to perform certain operation. Remember that using the same logic, you can also read other kinds of file. For instance, suppose instead of comma, the field separator is colon. So in that particular case, instead of using the IFS as comma, you can simply use the colon. So you will be able to read any formatted file. So that's all for today, guys. I hope you like the video. If you have any doubt, please comment it down. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.